come from California originally, did you?
Yeah.
He came from California today and he's been living there
for 2 years. Yeah. It's a bit like California weather here today, is it?
There's snow on the ground when we went.
Yeah, I guess it would be over there. Tell me, it's pretty unusual for a group such as yourselves, you know, who've got a tremendous sound. I want to congratulate you right now on the LP that you got out for trade. It's brilliant. And the kids are loving it here in Sydney. You went from the States over to England, and it was England that you got your big break in, wasn't it?
The American thing, it wasn't, you know, sort of working out. I mean, we weren't sort of very involved in the pop business in America. We more or less, like, played in clubs.
Yeah.
And then when we came to England, we decided we'd go straight for records and that was going to be it, you know. And we wanted to do things like we're doing. And we just waited, you know. And after waiting long enough, you know, it all happened.
So. Yeah. Your first big record in England was a thing called Love Her. That went to number one, didn't it?
No, that was the record before our first number one. One floundered about the charts. You know,
oh, I see. Yeah.
Sort of weeks and weeks.
Yeah.
Our first number one was Make It Easy.
Make It Easy on yourself. Yeah, that was a great sound too. Your big record that sort of took off really here for you was one that we'll play a little later on. And now that this LP has come out, I think, you know, that the Walker Brothers have certainly arrived here anyway, I'm sure, and you're going to do big things. You've got an unusual sound, a big driving sound. You sort of try for this every time. This is the sort of music that you like to sing all the time.
Yeah, well, it's a thing, you know. It's like you can have, you know, a few pieces, or you can have like a sort of a big thing, and it's nicer when it's big, you know.
Yeah. And what's happening now after you leave here? What happens to you after you leave Sydney? Well,
going up to Japan,
mm-hmm.
and see what's happening there.
Yeah.
We've got something to do there. And then we go on to, you know, California for, you know, a week or so, just kind of laying around, see the folks and all that, and then. Back to England. We'll have another tour there.
Fine. Well, look, I think we might go right now with the Sun Ain't Gonna Shine Anymore, which I think is probably the biggest record that you've had here up to date in Sydney Town, which is great. So we might go with that, eh? We're talking with John Mars of the Walker Brothers, and this is their big record, of course, The Sun Ain't Gonna Shine Anymore. Tell me one thing. There's many varied stories about how you all happened to get together. I believe you had a car accident or something with a drummer, and you sort of met up that way. Is that right or not?
This one is very stories. No, it was Scott and I started out, you know, this club thing we were doing, and Leeds sort of came in one night, and because, you know, we all had long hair and everything, you know, we had a home scene in this place, and so Leeds walked in one day and he said, you know, you're doing it all wrong. You should go to England, and we kind of said, well, you know, we sort of, you know, plane ride and things, and we kind of put it off, and finally we figured, you know, we might as well go.
Yeah.
That's how Leeds and we all sort of made it.
Yeah, and speaking of your hair, you've certainly got, you know, like there's a fine crop of it growing at the top of your head.
No, sure now.
You were sort of the first people in America, weren't you, to grow your hair long?
Yeah, we did it, and it was really a rough thing to do.
I suppose you got a bit of,
yeah, we did.
Ribbing about it, I guess. Yeah, fine. And you've got a new, you tell me there's a new LP coming out, is it right?
Yeah, we just finished one up. It'll probably should be out in England like next month. And it's got some pretty fired up things on it. Some of it's very, you know, nutty and, you know, just nice. I like this one. I think this one, the new one, is better than the one
in Portrait.
Yeah.
Well, Portrait's great, you know, and if it's better than Portrait, well, you know, I just don't know. I hate to think what's going to happen. The sale's going to go like the poor old record company's going to be bombarded. You've got two EPs out. That was kind of unusual. They were both released here at the same time. I Need You, with four great tracks on it. And also this solo EP, where you and Scott sort of work some fine material over. And we might play a track off this solo EP, your little version there of Sonny. How did you come to do that? That's the Bobby Hebb tune. What sort of made you...
Yeah, it's because I dig that song. You know, it's such a great tune. You know, I just had to do it.
Fine. Well, so we might just go with that one now. This is John Walker, or John Mars. I don't know what you prefer to be called, but I guess John Walker sounds a bit better, doesn't it? All right, the Walker Brothers. And here's John singing solo and Sonny.
That record there from John Walker, it's called Sonny, the tune that Bobby Hebb had about him a little while back. And I guess if you hear that, he'd probably snap his little brain, because that's brilliant, John. That's great. I like that record. And that's on the EP Solo, and you can probably buy that in your store right now. It's released out in the Bell and Phillips. Why don't you just a little bit about yourself, just before we go? I know you're so busy. busy and everything, and you're rehearsing and running around and pretty tired and everything after the trips and everything. But it said, I hear you were sort of wanting to become a history teacher or something, but you started funny, making money playing your guitar and singing and everything, so you gave all that idea away. What are your hobbies over there, John? What do you do in your spare time, if you've got any?
Race. I'm a GT. Race car, and I sort of hunted around tracks and things.
Great. Live dangerously, eh? Yeah, and what about your stage act? We've had reports, you know, that it's great and riotous and everything, and I think the kids are going to go down there and scream their little skulls off on the
big set. Yeah, that's gotten out of education. Well, most people, I guess, would expect that we, you know, sort of do ballads and things. And,
yeah.
Well, we don't. We do a couple of our records usually, because we couldn't, you know, I mean, you just can't carry 42 pieces around with you, you know what I mean? So we do, you know, more or less like an up-tempo sort of thing.
Fine. Well, it's been great talking to you, John. I want to thank you very much for coming in to seeing us here, you know, and I guess, you know, you've got to be off or anything. I see Sandy Patterson's here, and of course, gee whiz, I'd spot places for you being driven around by that K's rent a car girl there. You get all the good breaks, don't you? I got to sit in this studio and you're sort of motorized around town. Anyway, thanks very much for coming in, and I know that you're going to get a great reception in Sydney, and I hope that you go on from success to success, and I'm sure you will if you keep bringing up the gear that you are right now.
Thank you.
Okay, fine. We're talking with John Walker from the Walker Brothers, and don't you forget the big show on Saturday and Monday down there, the 21st and 23rd of January. It's going to be a wild thing, I want to tell you. So to finish off this little bit, we might go with a track off the LP Portrait, a little thing called Saturday's Child. It's a great record. That's a track off the LP Portrait by the Walker Brothers, and it's called Saturday's Child, and we were talking, of course, there with John Walker, or John Mouse, of the Walker Brothers, and you can see them down there at the stadium, and I want to tell you, you know, just having a little chat here off mic with John and everything, it's going to be a great show down there, and they're really going to turn it on for all the Sydney people, so we kind of hope that everybody in the world gets down there to the stadium to the big show on Saturday and Monday.